Howdy. Terra Remota, Emporda. We're here to understand that they have a pretty cool facility. Let's go learn about it.
Flame on.
About your vineyards, give us an idea of how the soil lends itself to the characteristics of your wine, yeah. And also the varieties that you're growing here.
Okay, so in Terra Remota we have here actually, we have totally 40 hectares, but from the 40 hectares we have planted 23 hectares. It's to maintain also the equilibrium into nature. Then from the 23 hectares that we have 12 parcels.
And the soil here,
Well, you can see, in fact, we have a spectacular granite soil, so that gives very nice minerality and freshness to our wines. And this is one of the main reasons why the owners, Marc and Emma, have chosen this place, because they fall in love with this soil here, with this granite soil.
Yeah, and of course, you guys are in perfect firing line for the Tramontana.
Yeah. So you see over here, we have the Syrah Alberas. So from here, the Tramontana comes very strong. And for this reason, we have planted all the vineyards facing here, yeah, to the south. So like this, the Tramontana passes through the vineyards exactly.
It takes all, blows all the moisture out. And takes all the, keeps the fungus.
Well, no, it's avoiding to give any additional pressure to the plants.
Ah, yeah, yeah. Because it's flowing with
exactly
growth,
flowing
as opposed
with, exactly,
to
this direction.
Obviously, the design and the architecture, yes, of the facility is very important, and obviously, it's no accident. So tell us a little more about it.
Well, the building was done with two architects from Barcelona, Nacho Ferrer and Pepe Cortés. The two architects in hand with the owner, Marc Bournazeau. So they have made the design, and everything was done to work with the gravity flow. So you can see, for this reason, we have the three levels. So it's really to work as most efficiently possible. So because our philosophy, in fact, is less that we manipulate the natural product, more that we keep his natural essence. So for this reason, everything was really studied and made that we less manipulate the grape as much as possible. Then the building have received two prizes, one for the design and the other one for the integration into the nature.
Yeah, which is done very nicely.
Exactly, and you can see on the roof, and then it has some vegetation. So what it makes, it retains the rainwater, and the rainwater goes after to a little lake that we have beside, and then we are using the rainwater for the irrigation system.
All right, so the design, so the wash-off or the runoff is actually designed into the building.
So exactly. So
then we have Tempranillo, then we have Cabernet Sauvignon, okay, and Syrah. These are the right wines. And for Rosé, we use Grenache and Syrah. Uh-huh. And for the white wines, we are using white Grenache, Chardonnay, and white Chenin. Painful to me, it's right through me, don't you understand? Oh, my little girl.
Poor, poor York. This is what becomes of all of us eventually. We come from the world, from the soil, and so we return. But maybe if we're lucky, we come back as wine.
Touched on, obviously, the design, and talked about the ceiling, and so now we're actually standing on the ceiling here.
Yeah, exactly.
We get a wonderful, like, that 360 perspective of the layout of the vineyards. And you said that this is where you typically start your tours.
Exactly. Well, we start over there, the tours. So we have a very nice view here. Here we have all the Sierra of Alberes. And here you can see we have all the Pyrenees. So it's an amazing view that we have here from this place.
And standing here, and probably from the perspective of the camera, you really can't tell that we're actually on a roof.
On the roof, yeah, no. You see, nature has taken its place here.
Yeah.
So it's very important for Terra Remota, all the concept of nature, respect to the nature. And also here, it's the vegetables here, and on the other side has taken its place. And here on spring, you see all the flowers flowering. So it's very special and very beautiful.
Okay, so we're speaking here about a production of about 80,000 to 100,000 bottles. And as you can see here, we are working with so the grapes are coming from here up inside. Then upstairs we have a machine that we make the steam so that we separate the grapes from the grape cluster. And then the grapes are falling directly inside here into the deposits. And then we're starting it's called in French the pigeage, that's made with the stick. So we are smashing the grapes during 3 to 4 weeks, once or twice a day. And then what we do is we take the whole mess, and when we go then we have the presses, and then we press out the wine.
In fact, all the winery, you can see how the way we are working, it's very, very clean. So for us, it's also the respect to the product that we are producing. So it's a natural product, so we have to work like in a kitchen, very clean.
Yeah.
So as you can see, we cannot have any contamination here. So at the moment you have any small contamination, the quality of the wine goes down. So for us it's really important to work very, very clean and respect the natural product. World is always changing.
So Camino takes 1 year, then we have another one because Adriana takes 2 years, and then Usted, the last one, it's 3 years of age.
As you've made clear to us, there was a third person.
Exactly. Oh.
So here we see Claude. Claude is the father of Emma. So Claude was also main part of this project. Unfortunately, he died in 2005. So he could not see finished the whole project because it was finished in 2006, and we had the first vintage also in 2006. So it was also the dream of Claude with his son-in-law Marc and Emma to create Terra Remota. And well, here we are in this fantastic tasting room where we have a great mission here to the barrels, to the aging room. Where we can have also sitting here, whole vision through the winery, so we can see like a three-dimensional process of all the vinification. And yes, it's a very special place because it's like a restaurant. It's open, you can sit down, and you have a fantastic view through the winery. And I think it's you cannot find a lot of places like this.
So tell us about the history of the cellar as well as the vineyard, and what you'd say the overall philosophy from kind of day one has been.
Okay, so the project had been started at the year 2000 when Marc and Emma found this place here, so they fell in love and they purchased 40 hectares. And from the 40 hectares, they have planted 23 hectares. Well, so it was a huge work because everything was in fact was wild forest. Yeah. So they had to prepare the whole ground. It took some years. So at the year 2003 and 2004, we have planted, and we had the first vintage on 2006. Heinz, he wanted to produce. And with a very high respect on the nature, this is our main philosophy, the respect on the nature. For this reason, for the 40 hectares that they have purchased, they only have planted 23 to maintain the equilibrium into the nature. Then the whole building was done in the sense that we work with the gravity flow and have given this high quality organic wines.
It was the timing of the finishing of the facility, as well as the first vintage, that was pretty much part of the plan as well. So, was it pretty much a plan to have the first vintage the same year that the facility was by design?
Exactly.
That's wonderful.
Dead, sold 36 months, so 3 years of aging. So this is our limited production of 2,000 bottles. So it's also the most expensive one. And here you can see Usted makes reference on Sir.
Yeah.
And what I have not explained before, of course, Adrian, it's the son of Marc and Emma. So to reference on their son, they put the name of Adrian. And Usted, it's the mister, it's the sir,
yeah,
of our production. And it's a very, very special wine with 60% of Grenache and 40% of Syrah. And yeah, for me, it's my Christmas wine, just saying.
Very good. Then she decides that. Somewhere else, babe. Yeah, there's nothing at all. But someday I'll be somebody. Let's touch on the family history.
Yeah, the family.
It's kind of important to the, you know, to the establishment.
So the reason why they came here is because the grandfather of Emma was Catalan, but he emigrates at the Civil War to the French side. So you can hear Marc Bournazeau, it's a French name, so they're living in Perpignan. And well, they wanted to come back to the origins of the family. For this reason, they came here back to Catalunya, and they have built up here Terra Remota. I have the great pleasure that you are here, so let's enjoy a Usted.
Ready?
I'm already filming.
Oh, you are?
Yeah, you don't, yeah, I'm already filming.
So now we are getting a real treat. Opened the Usted for us.
Of course.
There's the actual proof here. Who's this guy?
Michael.
So now there are officially 1,999 bottles.
Exactly.
Oops.
No. Right now, we have still some Usted, but
the most part of them, it's already sold out.
That.
But it's a wine that has a very strong potential. I say here we can speak about easily 15 to 20 years of aging in the bottle.
That is.
And you will find in all our wines a balance.
Yeah.
Never too much oak.
Yeah.
Just the right quantity of oak, and the fruit, the qualities of the fruit, it's there.
Yeah. The tannins are soft.
Thank you for this treat, and thank you for showing us around. And
you're welcome.
And for all the insight in the philosophy, the history. And of course, the brilliant design.
Thank you for coming.
Cheers. He needs more.
Exactly.
Behind the cameras, he's got the easiest job.
No.